Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Notre Dame. I'm sure that I've been here for 25 years, love it here. And we are hosting the BC Catholics Play Festival, obviously. It's the sixth year of, is it the sixth year, Charles?
Yes,
it's the sixth year, and we're very excited as drama teachers to be able to combine together with our classes and come up with something for this. This is a very student-directed project where they all write their own plays, and they direct them, and they do the lighting, they do the sound, and they do all everything for the play. So we're very excited to see what's going to happen from all the different schools. We are very lucky to have two amazing adjudicators tonight. And if we can get some lights in the house right there, just get the house lights up in the middle there. Great. Okay, so Anna Kuhman. Anna is very active in our community. She is a choreographer, she's an actress, she's a playwright, and she's a graduate of Notre Dame, which we're really excited about. She's from Capilano University as well. She's come to the music theater program there. She's going to be in Beauty and the Beast this fall as Babette. And she just finished her show that she wrote with her husband. And it's Circle Game, yes. It's called Circle Game. And they did it down at the Fire Hall, and it was a great success, a critical success on all aspects of it. So, Anna Kuhman! And Vincent Tong, I've known even longer than Anna Kuhman, since he was a little mite. And a great singer, actor, dancer, fighter, voiceover in a lot of cartoons. I just heard The Deep, if anybody sees that. And what's the horsey show?
My Little Pony.
My Little Pony. You know that I have two little girls. And he voices a lot of characters in that. Apparently there's a new pony coming out. What's the new pony called?
His
name is Featherbangs. He also will be in Beauty and the Beast, and he will be an amazing LeFou. A very physical guy, very amazing actor in his own right today. Vincent Tong! So we're going to bring up our first cast. They are from Archbishop Carney Secondary. They are called Locked In. Sponsored teacher is Mr. Charles Harris. And they will be introducing themselves. Here they come.
Watching us right now.
Well, I mean, if they're staring
being trapped in a room by a psycho with a PA system full of people that I don't actually like is just so fun.
Don't worry, I'll get a way out of here.
Oh, you think this is a game? Take something seriously for once.
I am taking it seriously, and I don't need you to figure it out.
Fine. You want to play like that? We'll play like that. Get ready to be taken down.
Girls, you're with me.
I don't think this
is
such a...
Oh, thanks for leaving me with these tools. Fine. I'll just show that I'm smarter than all of you combined.
There's got to be something in here, some sort of clue to get us out.
Don't worry, we're going to find something.
Don't worry, have you met the girl?
Says you. You're the kind of person who, when someone first meets you, they don't like you. And then they get to know you, and they really don't like you. So I'm sorry if I'd rather not be second with you longer than absolutely necessary.
You're the one that got us into this. We've been searching in this room for nearly half an hour. I cannot believe that of all the people I had to be stuck in a room with, it had to be you, 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 and especially you.
For your information, there are plenty of people who would love to be trapped in a room. I, for one, know how to have a good time.
Well, there won't be any good times.
Yeah, that's right. I can only have a good time under two conditions. One of them, there's a mirror in front of me. Whenever I'm down, a mirror brings me right back up. And the second one, I have access to frozen sticks. And guys, I'm not getting either of those.
You are unbelievable.
Oh, but you've ever lost one, man?
Hey,
bring
me in back. Do you think it's a hint?
Yeah, I think we just need to...
Look, there's four pictures and he's gesturing a different letter to sign language each.
Oh, great, Nancy Drew. Let me just reach into my magic bag and pull out my sign language dictionary and figure this out.
Don't be so dramatic. But the pictures are all letters, and the code has to be a number.
Maybe each letter could represent a number.
Becca, you said you know some sign.
So it's 3, 7, 18, 12. Right?
Yeah, we should probably look at the different order that the numbers can be arranged in, though.
I just thought of something else.
What is it?
Everything in this room is connected. It's like one large puzzle, and I think part of what we need is to get to what the guys are looking at right now.
Why are we standing at this?
I'm staring at it because I'd like to find a piece of the clue that could possibly get us out of here. You two are staring at it because you want to appear smart.
Okay, come here. We need to distract them from the picture so we can get a closer look.
What do you plan to do?
Oh, you'll see.
You said distract them. I can be distracted. Just say the word razzle, and I'll bring the dazzle. This is the part where you guys are supposed to say razzle, and then I do something entertaining, and stuff. There were an audience in front of me, I was trying to amuse.
Think seriously, this isn't a one-act play.
You're not gonna hurt them or harm them in any way, right?
No, just think, how do we get inside them?
A scalpel. An ice pick for feeling a bit more pride.
You're disgusting.
You two, please. We need to focus. We can't distract them unless we understand them first.
Well, our fawn would rather die than be proved wrong or insufficient.
Oh. And Seth is quite confident, specifically in his look. Perhaps there's something there.
Or a lack thereof.
And Kodak, he just follows Seth, and he doesn't take anything seriously. Neither of them.
Okay, Jax, it's time to bring the razzle.
And
the dance.
Which way to the beach, boy?
White pie?
You mean, que se lano?
Playing with a stapler? testing me here. But you need to know that in the school of tolerance, I'm only a C student. Help times infinity. Thank you. Amen.
I don't think that really did much. This place doesn't even have a bathroom.
Or a place to refill my water bottle. I'm thirsty.
I'm lactose. lactose intolerant.
Well, maybe our fudge. Just give me the papers.
Maybe you just find your own clues.
Real mature.
Hey, boys, cuddle up. Our fudge. You examine this. Kodak, you read this. I'll supervise. Ready and brave.
Nice try. Hey, for effort, that one's yours, and you can have this one.
We're never going to find a way out of this room with the way they're digging like animals.
You for one thing, and the skill is not. Nice work! What is that? That is done nice vacation.
Yeah. Check this. There's an ad for a chalet near the mountain. What a coincidence.
A coincidence? I don't believe in coincidence. Let me see that. 154 W. Laurier Street, 241 Coupe. 241. 241. It's a code, a number code, 241.
What about the other part?
Yeah, Laurier. Isn't that old dude who ran Canada?
The Prime Minister? Perhaps. W. Laurier, Wilfrid Laurier, possible combinations are 1841 birth, 1919 death, 1896 when he became Prime Minister, and 1911 when his term ended.
Dude, you're like a walking history book.
We got this in the bag.
All right, we need to figure out all the possible combinations of these numbers. Or should I say, permutations? See, it's a math joke, and permutations.
This is ridiculous. I'm gonna go talk to him. Hello, tall. Dark.
Ah! obnoxious and airy.
What?
Come on, guys.
What is it? What could an idiot like you possibly have found?
Yeah, you're as useless as a white crayon.
Stop agreeing with me.
You stop agreeing with me.
Good. Fine.
Focus, please.
Can we just take a minute to look at what is right in front of us?
Yeah, the painting seems to be saying something. He's pointing. Maybe he's pointing at something outside of the painting?
Yeah, he seems to be pointing.
Sheet music?
Maybe you have to sing a song.
Oh, and dance?
I don't know what that was. And more importantly, I don't want to know, nor do I ever want to see it again. Maybe it's Morse code.
Yeah, it's possible this could have happened.
No, you couldn't, Kodak. You're a dimwit.
So I would just like to point out that while all of you have been talking, I've been figuring out what's on this. At least it's some sort of Morse code variation, but I'm not totally sure what it means yet. Fine, I guess you're taking those.
Finally, some sense in this room.
I
don't
smell anything.
Come on. I'm gonna be out of here before you can say the world's longest word.
Ah, yes. Pneumonotrimic microscopic silico volcanokinosis. It's a lung disease.
He knows big words.
I think I speak Viking.
What a legend.
Viking?
Yeah, Viking like Morse.
I believe the word you're looking for is Norse. And Norse is the culture, not the language.
Same thing.
Boy Scouts.
Okay, so if you look at this, think of all the coordinates as dots and the 8 bits as dashes.
So it's dot, 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 dash, dash.
That's 3.
I'll go put it in.
And then it's dash, 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 dot.
9.
Then it's dot, 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 dot.
Wait, are you guys big boxing? I'm good on that, you know?
What the name of all this? Holy is that. Dealing with baboons, I swear to all.
Oh, those are the monkeys with the pink butts.
Awesome. Will you just shut up and focus?
So that was a 5.
Wait, Codex Morse.
I was talking about the Morse code for
Of course.
The last one is dot, 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 dash.
That's 4.
Worked.
One lock down, 3 more to go.
All right, boys, let's see if you can find anything else in these papers.
Now that we have that figured out, let's see what our fondue note has to say.
Are you sure you want to do this? Go behind their backs again?
I say we let them in on this. It's the wrong thing to do.
Do you guys want to get out of here or not? According to this...
I'm sorry, forgive me. I'm just looking for something here. What is it?
Can I help you?
No, you can't help me. I was just looking for... Thank you.
So, the key... It should be somewhere here.
Looking for this?
How?
Oh, I just sniped it when I was looking for that piece of music. You know what? I was very disappointed. I thought it would be better than this. Trying to trick us to get out of the room and leave us here. I'm disappointed in Britain.
No, cry me a river. I'm used to disappointing men.
I guess I'm just so used to always being right and doing things on my own. And when I let other people do things for me, I feel like I'm not accomplishing anything.
I know, we know, but you have to realize that helping someone isn't the same as
overtaking them or replacing them. Look, we know you're smart, but you have to learn how to cooperate.
You know what? You guys are right. Truce. I want this over as bad as you, and together I think we can figure it out.
Truth. Come on, guys. Now that we got that sorted, we have four locks, who knows how many keys. You guys lay out yours, and we'll lay out ours.
Sounds good.
All right.
So now we know we have the key, but is it the key to the door?
No, it's the key to the White House. Of course it's the key to the door.
Come on, don't be so sure. Here. Didn't work.
Huh, we'll be alright.
They were actually right. Oh boy, their brain cells collided. And now, this is quite the achievement, and I'm very happy for you, but we need to focus here on the issue that,
we don't have the key!
Okay, now calm down, let me see the key. Lewis, that's what the key says.
And there's a cup on the back, a teacup.
Oh, Alice in Wonderland. What a lovely story. I remember my mom reading me that. Yeah, my sister really liked that book.
I saw it earlier. Well done. Maybe you're not totally useless.
The key!
There's a key. Could this be the key to the door?
I think so.
Okay, so two down, two more to go.
And we sort of figured out the sign language. We just don't know the order.
Maybe it's the mountain ranges in the background.
Yeah, they could fit together like puzzle pieces.
Okay, so the code's gotta be 3, 18, 12, 7. Okay, did you guys find anything else? Anything else?
The newspapers.
So you did find something with that?
Yes, we did. It has something to do with Wilfrid Laurier. We're confident about that. We hashed out a few dates.
Warning. Warning. You all have 2 minutes until you will be terminated. Oh,
come on, guys. We really need to hurry up.
All right, 241. The beginning of the combination.
This coupon is for February 17th.
Is 1919 one of your combinations?
February the 17th, 1919, the date of Laurier's death.
Holy, how do you guys remember this? I can barely even remember my own birthday. And we all know history teachers aren't that great.
Okay, so the code's gotta be 241-1919.
Okay, well, what are we waiting for? Let's try out the key and get out of here, because I want to go home.
Me too.
Arfog, I think you should be the one that does this part.
Bring it.
Class Secondary with Unreal Reality. Realty. All right. Next up, we have Holy Cross with Unreal Reality, and they will be here to explain their show. Here they go.
Hi, my name is Colton Ludwar, and I'm from Holy Cross, and I'm the main writer and director of the script Unreal Reality. Based off kind of a reality, kind of like a Bachelor type reality show, except there's kind of like a twist. There's always this rumor in a reality show that is it really reality or is it scripted? But with ours, it is scripted, so we kind of see the behind the scenes of the scripted reality TV show. So that's Unreal Reality. I hope you enjoy it.
Far from it.
Corinne, you're not the
only one in this competition. We all have a good chance of being Logan's wife. Isn't that right, Dolores?
Huh? Who said my name? Where am I?
Just beat old lady and barely in this competition anyway.
So that's my day. People respect their elders.
Shut up.
I'm sorry about her, Dolores. There you go. All cozy.
Girls, get ready. It's almost time for the party. Talked about this. I'm Hunter, remember?
Are you? Oh, I'm sorry. All you young people say you
can Let's go party, girls! And cut! Much, much better, girls. However, Dolores, what did we say about touching the moneymaker?
No one! I mean, no one can touch Hunter's face! Someone's made up to be smooth.
But, sir, it's as handsome as ever.
No one asked you, Jeffrey!
Of course, sir. Sorry, sir.
I need more powder. Please, get ready for the party scene. We start in line.
Well, that's a nice napkin, isn't
it? I can't believe we landed these roles. We are totally gonna be famous.
I know. It's been a crazy 2 months since we first started filming. I cannot believe we got chosen to be written in for the finale! After all this craziness is done, we can finally get the department we've been seeing before and start our acting careers.
It's going to be amazing! It's funny to think people actually think this show is real. I wonder who Logan will pick. I heard Hunter is actually letting Logan pick the winner himself!
Really? I wonder if he's gonna choose.
Meh, doesn't matter. We're gonna be famous anyways.
Ladies, hurry up. We're about to start rolling. Everyone, places.
Episode 16, party scene, day one.
Dolores.
Yay!
Really, that's
seat. Such a good place for a commercial. And Jocelyn, could you be any more frickin' fantastic? Those pushes and nudges you threw in there made me want to scream!
You don't
touch me, Jeffrey!
Of course, sir. Sorry, sir.
You ruined my Versace jacket. You're gonna have to buy me a new one, Jeffrey.
Of course, sir. I'm so sorry, sir.
Yeah. Okay, good job, everyone. Dolores and Logan, we're here for Horizon soon, so meet me outside in 15, okay? Dolores. 15? Yeah. Jeffrey, with me.
Yes, sir, I'm coming.
Hey! So, I don't mean to criticize, but don't you just think you're being a little too pushy out there?
No, not really, Corinne. It's just acting.
Right. Acting.
That pressure. Really great. We should do it again sometime.
Yeah, I had fun. How does lunch tomorrow sound?
Sounds good.
What do you think you were doing?
Huh?
I overheard you talking to Logan. You know, he's not supposed to be involved with anyone while filming.
Oh, relax, Corinne. We were just having some harmless fun.
Well, I guess I could have some harmless fun as well.
What do you mean?
Well, it's not like you two are anything serious. Besides, I've caught Logan checking me out all day.
You?
Excuse me?
Well, Logan has a tight end, honey, it isn't you.
You know what, Jocelyn? I'm suddenly thinking there's only room for one person in that apartment.
Yeah, your big head takes up all the space.
Oh!
Right. I'm sorry, Corinne. Maybe that was a little too far. You know, we're friends. We should be supporting each other. We can't let the show take over us.
You know what? You're right.
I can't get this off. Corinne, can you help me take off my makeup?
Of course, Bessie. Why don't you come over here? The light is much, much better over here.
Did you get it off?
Yes, I did.
Oh, thank you.
If you need me, I'll be in my room.
Good night, Corinne.
Dolores and Logan, hurry up. We're leaving for Horizons now.
want to go on the honeymoon?
No, I haven't actually.
If I can make a suggestion, maybe Fiji? I hear it's especially beautiful this time of year. What do you think?
Well, I guess.
Oopsie! You ripped my dress! It was an accident!
Right, an accident!
That's not two things rationally! Hunter!
Get up!
Please, calm down! We're just about to start!
But we can't, not without Jessica!
Don't worry about Jessica. She's probably just running late. I mean, who would want to miss the final rose ceremony?
I mean, I guess you're right.
Of course I am. Now, everyone ready, and clean this up. Everyone places. That means you too, Dolores.
But I can't find my knitting needles.
Just forget about your knitting needles. We'll find them later. Perfect. Now, everyone's ready. Except for Jessica.
Wait, Hunter, can I talk to you?
No, Jocelyn, we're just about to start.
But it's really important.
Then I guess it's just gonna have to wait then.
Huh. Episode 16, rose ceremony, take one.
Okay, rolling, and action. At long last, the time has come. The event everyone's been waiting for. The final rose ceremony. Here, Logan will choose one of the remaining girls to be his wife. I know you guys are excited, so let's get to it. Logan, I'm sure you've thought long and hard about this.
Indeed I have, Hunter.
And I'm sure whomever you pick, that you guys will live happily ever after.
One can only hope.
Logan, have you made your decision, or do you need more time?
I have made my decision, Hunter.
Excellent. So I ask, for the final time, who will receive this rose?
The woman who received this rose and be my lawfully wedded wife is Jessica.
Why? You can't pick her! She's dead!
Wait, you knew?
Dead? She can't be dead. She's supposed to be my wife.
Well, too bad. She's dead. Dead as a doornail. I saw with my own eyes. Dead. Laying on the bathroom floor.
I'm sorry, Logan. I know this is hard for you.
You're just trying to get him to pick you!
Don't be insane, Corinne. I'm just trying to comfort him. You know, something, good? Wife would do in a situation like this?
Just dead.
Are you calling me a bad wife?
You said it, not me.
I'll have you know, I'd make an amazing wife.
Right.
Well, since Jessica's dead, you're gonna have to pick one of us.
I don't think that's... Pick! I picked Dolores! You know. Not so fast! Guards, grab her!
You thought you'd get away with it, didn't you, Dolores?
Get away with what?
Stop with the act, Grandma. We're all on you.
I didn't do anything.
You didn't do anything? Really? Then why did I find a knitting needle lodged into Jessica's neck?
I didn't kill her, I promise.
But Dolores couldn't have killed Jessica. She's such a sweet little lady. But she did love me. It was her knitting needle. It couldn't have been anyone else. And you almost got away from it.
I didn't kill her!
Save for the judge! Guards, take her away!
To where, boss?
Oh. Didn't think about that. Just lock her in a room and then call the police.
Got it, boss.
But please, let me go! I'm not innocent, please!
I can't believe this has happened. Why, Dolores? Why?
I know this is shocking for you, but the fact of the matter is that you still need a wife, so who will it be? Corinne or Jocelyn?
I have to pick one of these two.
Excuse me! Well, have you know that you'd be lucky to have either one of us?
Yeah! I mean, look at Jocelyn. She's amazing.
Aw, do you really mean that?
Yes, I do. I'm sorry for the way I acted around Logan. How about we promise to never let a little boy get between us again?
What did you expect?
Oh, I have to pick one of these two?
I mean, I would have jumped you right in the spot.
Crit?
Well, folks, was that an amazing season finale or what? Looks like Logan didn't find love after all. I guess we're going to have a season two. I hope you had a wonderful time watching our show, Logan Looking for Love, and I do hope you come back next season. As always, I'm Hunter Walkwood. Good night, everybody. And cut.
Oh, man, Jeffrey, can you believe that ending?
No, I can't, sir.
I know. It was crazy.
Sure was.
Good work, Jeffrey. You can take the rest of the day off.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Don't touch me, Jeffrey!
Of course, sir. I'm so sorry, sir.
Just leave, Jeffrey.
Goodbye, sir.
Oh my gosh, you're so cute.
Hey, girls, how's your weekend?
Oh, gosh, I cannot stand Kendall.
I wish I was Kendall.
So my party this weekend, I was thinking we do a theme. Oh my gosh, great idea. Toga party.
No way, Haley. Tropical theme?
For sure.
Then we can wear our matching bikinis we got last year.
Last year? Are you kidding me? No. Let's go get new ones after school.
OMG, great idea. Shopping trip.
But like our old ones can be like retro.
Oh my gosh, you're so cute.
Come on guys, let's go. I need to get a front row seat in class.
I really wish I could tell Athena that, but I have
have to be this perfect little child that my parents think I am. I have to put up this stupid facade at school. I wish I could tell my parents everything about my life, especially about the person that I love. Ugh!
Text me if your schedule opens up. You can stay in the lobby.
This is it, home. If you can talk to him, you are strong, you are brave, you are beautiful.
But you're not her.
Oh, I love him so much I can just break out into song, but this isn't High School Musical. And the cool kid doesn't end up with the loser. So I guess I just gotta go my own way. I'm so sorry!
Watch it.
Oh my god, he just talked to me!
Job to teach you everything. You're smart enough. Why do you even need help?
I'm sorry, I'm not smart enough to be your friend.
No,
but she's worth her weight in gold. I wish I didn't have to miss Blair's party. I'm losing everything. What am I supposed to do? Not support my family?
But I know him. I know everything about him. Like his favorite color, his favorite sports team, where he eats at lunch, his route home, how long it takes. Is that desperate? No. I think that's normal.
I've known him my whole life, and I know when something's wrong. He just seems so, I don't know, not himself. It's barely noticeable, but it's there.
Oh, I would just kill for him to notice me! Well, maybe not kill. Maybe like punch. Or like lightly tap. I'm not very good at confrontation.
My parents think they can make up for their absence with a $500 shopping spree and a new car. They don't understand that I give up anything just to be with them. Sometimes I think they might give up their next trip to Paris for, I don't know, family game night, a home-cooked meal. Man, I wish.
I wish I had the confidence to storm up to him and say,
I can't. I can't do it anymore.
Carter, I know you don't know me very well, but I am in love with you. Let's go on a date.
But it's just me. Who would ever choose me?
Thank you.
she think that that's okay? Oh gosh, what do I do? I mean, I can't let her go back to that hall, but nobody deserves that.
Somebody's got a temper. yourself, or are you just gonna keep pacing to be our hole in the floor?
Hey, we got a comedian in the room.
Come on, man, lighten up. I'm sure this is all just some sort of a mix-up. Everything will be sorted out in an hour or so, and then we can all go home. I'm Casey. And you are?
I'm trying to figure out how to get out of here. It's cute that you have your little breakfast club going on, but I'm not just gonna sit back and hope for the best. So if you don't mind, I'd like to try
and- by me. If you don't want to tell us your name, I'm sure we can think of lots of others that can suit
you. Step.
Subjects, prepare yourselves for the first examination. This exercise will focus on an individual's intelligence. As you can see, there's an equation on the board. Solve it and you will advance to further testing.
Math? Are you kidding me? What's a math equation going to prove? For all we know.
Well, seeing that reps are synthetically manufactured, they're basically supercomputers. So, I'm guessing they're hoping that the rep will solve this equation.
Okay, then case solved. Look at this freak. She's a walking computer. Hey, why are we even here? It's clearly her.
Accusing her doesn't do anything to help your case here. You can either help us out or sit back and do nothing. It's your choice.
Whatever. This is a waste of time anyways.
Well, the integral number and then the Euler's number.
I'm sorry, what are you talking about? I can't figure this out. What kind of equation is this? I have no idea.
Up already.
What if I can't solve this? What do you think they're going to do to me?
No way. Just, can you just calm down? All right?
I think I got it.
How'd you do that?
It's actually pretty simple. Do you want sure to dumb it down for you?
You barely even had to work for that answer. That is normal. Hey, come on. I think it's pretty obvious who the replicant is here. Can we be done with this so I can go home, please?
Subject 1604, we understand you may be experiencing frustration. We have the confidence that our test will deliver accurate results. Subject 1605, your answer is correct. We will now proceed with the second examination. This exercise will determine an individual's ability to utilize deductive reasoning to come to a conclusion. Listen carefully. Two girls ate dinner together. They both ordered iced tea. One girl drank hers very quickly and had finished five in the time it took the other to drink just one. The girl who drank one died, while the other survived. All of the drinks are poisoned. How did the girl who drank the most survive?
A stupid riddle? Hey, Siri, who do you think we are, detectives? Give me a break. Is the fact that they haven't extracted you yet. I can solve this one for you. Easy. Obviously, the girl that drank more had enough to flush it out of her system.
Yeah, I don't think that's right. It's a little too easy.
What if the sugar in the iced tea neutralized the poison?
But it doesn't make sense, because if both drinks are poisoned, and only one girl died.
Since you seem to know everything, why don't you tell us then? As any, but what now?
Well, seeing that we all seem to agree that Becca's answer is correct,
That's wrong.
What now?
How could that be wrong? It makes sense, doesn't it? And what do you think happened?
Poison in the ice.
How does that make any sense? They both had ice in their drinks.
Exactly. One girl drank her drinks very quickly, while the other drank hers very slowly. When he drank hers quickly, didn't allow time for the ice to melt, while the one who drank hers slowly did, therefore releasing the poison into the drink.
That is completely ridiculous.
Subject 1606, your answer is correct. All subjects, prepare yourselves for the next examination. This exercise focuses on an individual's ability to use emotion and ethics to come to a rational conclusion. The scenario you will be given is primitive and imperative in serving our test purposes. There is a runaway trolley barreling down the railway tracks. Ahead are five people tied up and unable to move. The trolley is headed straight for them. You are standing next to a lever. If you pull this lever, the trolley will switch to a different set of tracks. However, suppose the person on the other set is someone close to you, someone you care about, perhaps a sister or a father, maybe a lover. What do you do? Consider your answer carefully, and we will individually call on you for your response.
So, do you save the life of one?
For the lives of many. They want us to think practically, cold, calculated, like a machine.
That's horrible. How can they expect us to possibly answer a question like that?
Do you want to find out what happens if they don't?
Hey, take it easy.
Don't tell me what to do. I'm not touching that, brother. Family comes first.
What if those five people had families too?
Oh, if it was your girlfriend on the train track, pretty boy, what would you do then?
I hate to admit it, but he's right. I don't think I could live with myself and living with someone I love die. It makes two of us care.
Really? Someone as cold and calculating as yourself would do that. Or maybe you're just putting on a show for us.
I'm agreeing with you. As if your ego could use another boost.
Subjects, please state your answer as I call your identification number. A simple yes or no response is adequate. Subject 1604, do you pull the lever and change the tracks?
No.
Subject 1605.
No.
Subject 1606. Subject 1607. State your answer.
No.
Subject 1608.
Yes.
Thank you for your responses. We have almost collected enough data now to reach our conclusion. You'll be given your final instructions shortly.
How could you say that?
If it was me on those train tracks, I'd tell you to pull the lever. It's the right thing to do.
It could have been someone you love.
Those five people had families too. They had fathers and mothers, maybe even brothers, sisters. Think about how many people are really affected.
Oh, no, no. Those are hypothetical people you'll never meet. You're calculating. Save the life of many. One means nothing to you. That's more practical, isn't it? You've been manipulating this from the start, haven't you?
How dare you talk to him like
knock
that?
Knock it off!
Shut up, you report! You're covering for it? Knowing that harboring replicants is an offense, you know!
How dare you!
No, how dare you! Maybe they're all going to play right to your game, but I'm not falling for it. Should have known right for the entire
time. Stop! I'm sick of you pretending like you're somehow better than me! Better than all of us! What is it? Is your inflated ego too big for a thick skull? What is it? Tell me. That's what I thought.
You know, the more I think about it, the more I wonder how you've actually contributed to any of this besides being stubborn, wrong, and throwing blame on everyone else.
What do you say?
Well, replicants don't get scared, so you almost had me fooled there, but they are smart.
Smart enough to play dumb.
You have been throwing the blame off yourself this entire time.
Oh, you. One way or another, I'm getting out of here! I'm not ready to die! Not yet!
Replicant or not, the world is better off without people like you.
I almost feel sorry for you.
Subjects, we have come to a conclusion. When you hear your number, please exit the testing facility. The door will open for you as you leave, and someone will await you outside. All subjects, step forward. Subject 1605. Subject 1606.
Come on, kid. Let's get out of here.
I have no idea. I don't understand. I'll have the test.
Don't you get it? It's not just run the test for our answers.
Subject 1604.
Wait, that's not right, though. Are you sure you calculated everything? There's no way it could be one of us. Casey, tell them, please.
Subject 1608. Subject 1607, do not attempt to leave the facility. Remain where you are, and we will exit the control room and begin in a moment.
Begin what? Wait. No, wait. I'm not a replicant. Casey, I'm not. I swear I'm not. Casey, where are you going? Come back. This must be a mistake.
Nobody cares for your pain, damn husky. You're lucky you're even here.
Okay. All right, guys. Let's settle down here. We've got a big day ahead of us. All right. So, Mikey, I want you to take Victor, and I want you to head to the lowest levels and see what you can find. Howie, take Declan and set up shop at Site 3. Joe, I want you to take the rookie and scout up Site 5. Keith, Christian, and I will stay here and work at home base. All right, let's go. Boss, what's that noise? What noise? That rumble.
Could be earthquake.
Don't be stupid.
You know, it almost sounds like the elevator.
Or like a jet.
Nothing's the matter, is it?
Everyone shut up!
Remind me I kill them every day by making them work down in this lab.
Spisk or life behind bars. You killed Chris and another. Do you really want to spend the rest of your life in prison?
We don't have to see you, then yes.
Oh, you're a real piece of work.
I'll listen to both of you! You back off! Brothers, let's figure out how to get out of here first. We get at each other's throat. Stop! Stop!
So, how many of you want to look for water? Well, you know, boss, I'd go, but I can't exactly walk.
That's okay, you can stay here, Joe. All right, well, seeing as we were all civil and voted on it, let's go look for water. Howie, I want you to take Declan and head to the east tunnels and look for any source of water you can find. And Mikey and Victor, head to the west tunnels and look for the same. Get
what?
Looking for something is a good idea.
Why not?
You're sending out search parties.
It would be better for the rookie, better for any one of us, to live with some hope for life than just the certainty of death.
Huh? You care about them?
We care about everyone down here, some more than others. Maybe your brother first, your boss. Maybe your boss first, your brother second.
Yeah. We used to be friends. We used to like each other.
Well, that was before you drove Chris's head into a pole.
Sometimes I wish you'd been in that car.
Come on!
Will you hurt? Let's go. Come on! Watch the door. We talk to someone.
Guess you can start figuring out a ration plan.
You have me working on a boss.
Joe's hurt.
Justa? This ain't gonna help.
Fine. We'll do ourselves.
You know, we spent 15 years working together.
Hey, you know what?
Yeah, I think we have.
It's been a good couple of years, hasn't it, Keith?
To say the least. Remember the time? Who was it? Was it Howie?
Yeah, we thought we'd get a wash down here. I remember that clearly. I remember us being so scared of being laid off by the union that when we snuck our wives down here, we labeled them city council visitors. They had no clue.
All within regulation, am I right?
All within something for sure. I can't wait to tell that story. No, I think it's good. You can see it. It's okay. Hey, Keith, why don't you take the night off too?
Sure, boss?
Yeah, I'll be okay here.
Take care.
Boss, I was just thinking. What if they come back and they need help?
Then they wake us up, I suppose.
We keep someone on watch just in case.
Tell you what, I'll stay here and continue working until we get back.
If you want, boss, you can wait for me in 2 hours. I'll keep watch.
I'll do that. Thanks, Jess.
Why did I offer to this? I hate the dark. Now I'm all alone in it. Me. Got to go crazy down here, all alone.
Who's that? Mikey?
It's Howie. What happened?
Declan's dead.
What the hell? What do you mean dead?
Someone killed him with this pickaxe.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Wake up, please.
Okay.
covered in blood!
It's dead.
What?
He's dead.
What? Why? What
happened? Someone murdered him.
Who?
I didn't get a good look.
Keith!
I heard. I think it must be your brother.
Your brother hates everyone here. He hates you especially. Your brother's practically a psycho. My brother's not a killer, and you know that.
Boss, are we gonna die?
Well, not this again.
Justin, I don't have time for this anymore. Howie, take care of him. I swear, if he makes one peep, none of you are getting paid.
We're gonna kill him,
Louis. Yes, boss.
Shut up. Boss, what are we gonna do?
We're gonna stay here.
What?
What do you propose we do?
Look for him.
Look for who?
The killer.
And who is this killer?
Well, this isn't it kind of obvious?
No, it is not.
Joe, like Joe said, if one hates you, it hates his place.
Your brother is not a killer.
But Chris. You know what? I'm gonna go look for him.
And do what?
Kill him!
No, you are not!
If you aren't gonna save us, I am!
I won't let you kill my brother on a hunch.
This isn't a hunch! I know it's him!
It could be a... You don't know that!
Listen, stop defending the little brat called brother. I see it in his eyes. He's crazy!
I'm not letting you kill him!
Let go of me!
No! Why would you be sorry? I just lost my best friend and possibly my brother, or both, and I don't know what's worse. Why would you be sorry? Boss, was that Keith?
I think so.
It's the killer. We're all gonna die! Howie, what did I say about Justin? Boss,
that was Howie.
Howie? I can't do this, boss. I just saw Declan die, right before my eyes.
Howie, you just need to calm down.
I can't stay here.
Howie, if you go off in those mine shafts, you're going to die.
We stay in this mine, we all die.
Howie, just come back.
Stay here. Howie, don't leave. Howie! Howie! Damn it! Justin, stay with Joe, no matter what happens, stay with him!
Yes, boss. What if that was a foreman dying? What if the killer comes?
Oh, well, we're just gonna have to get him first, won't we? We got this.
What? We're gonna kill him?
Well, yeah, if it comes to it, I don't want to die.
What? Just go look for him.
No, the foreman told us to stay right here. It's safe here,
What if the foreman's the killer?
That doesn't make any sense. You gotta stay here, be calm.
What if it's true? What if he's the killer?
No, Justin, please.
Go look and see.
No! Please don't go! I'll be all alone!
Take this.
Justin, I can't move!
I'll be just fine, Joe.
Don't leave me! Your mic can be anywhere!
I'll be right back.
Justin, please! No!
Okay, Joe. It's okay. It's all right. We'll just sit here and pray.
They hate me. They really do. They hate me, but I do not hate them. Ever since I was a little boy, I always wanted to be an American. I do not know that. I knew what they were telling us was lies. But now that I see they really are hateful. They push me, they shove me. I know Vern should not do this to me, but he made you eat the different table alone, sleep outside by yourself. He does it. Look, I'm talking to this. Am I crazy? Maybe. But I kept that thought. That all us miners could be together. I've already done things that deep down that F and there's no stopping me. Boss, I would not be with him now after he jumped back on. But the thought was so powerful. It's used. I know I would not be with him now after all that time. But if it works like my dream said it, then I'd be happy. Or at least free of the pain.
Yes, he's resting. Just look at that.
Good. Yeah. You know, Victor, we never really talked before.
Justin, go.
I mean, I saw Mikey treating you like a piece of dirt.
No, Justin, it's fine.
Yeah. You seem like a great guy, Victor.
Justin, I'm used to not having friends in this country. They think I am a communist or something.
What? That's just silly.
Crazy, right? If the KGB cared about the thoughts of coal miners, they'd all go crazy listening to our thoughts. Especially him.
Is it?
Yes. But you think it is normal for Russian to come to America in the middle of the Cold War? Now that is crazy. I even thought that if friends or something, we accept it. Crazy.
Well, I'll be your friend later.
Maybe Justin?
Yeah.
That means a lot to me, Justin. Thank you. Can I tell a secret to my friend?
Okay.
Who the killer is?
The killer?
Mikey, the former driver. I saw him do it. I saw him kill the first night.
But why?
Maybe he stopped having acceptance from him. He wanted to be accepted. Killing his little brother.
Chris?
Yes, Chris.
I don't want it to make sense, but it does.
I don't want it to make sense either, but the mind makes a man go mad.
Are you making?
Oh.
Victor, I haven't seen you since this whole mess happened there. Are you all right?
I'm fine, sir. And you, sir?
I'm doing okay myself.
Even after...
After what? Mourning the loss of your brother. What?
You had to kill him to stop him, no?
Kill Mikey? What the hell? Why? Why would I have to do such a thing?
Boss, Mikey's the killer.
Justin, we've been over this. That's only a fear.
No, then you saw him.
Saw him?
Yes, sir.
You saw Mikey kill someone.
I was with him, sir.
He took my pickaxe and ran on ahead. I saw two lights go off, and then one turned on, race on ahead. I ran, sir. I'm sorry. Why am I kidding?
I did he say anything?
No, sir. I think it was because he wanted your approval.
It's my fault, isn't it?
No.
I drove him mad.
No, it's not your fault. It was his own weakness that drove him, and you just pushed him along. And then, yeah.
Do you know where he is?
No,
Justin. Saying he's dead.
Like what?
Speak of the devil. Michael.
What?
Why?
What?
Why? Why didn't you kill her?
Do you think I'm a killer?
Victor saw you.
Victor? Brother, it was Victor! I saw him do it! Just now!
No! You are. You're the killer, or I made you the killer. I tried to help you, but I only pushed you along. I did all I could, but it only drove you to insanity. I can't help you anymore, Mikey.
What? Brother, you're not gonna kill me. That doesn't make any sense. I saw it. Victor do it, Justin. I've known you for years. Make him think.
You hate Victor, Mikey. You hate him for who he is, where he's from. You're just a pity lad.
No. Please. I saw him do it. He killed them.
I can't believe you anymore, Mikey. You killed my friends. They're all that matter to me anymore.
I'm your brother. I shouldn't matter, too.
You did once. I thought I could help you, Mikey. I thought things could be different.
Help me? You caused my problems!
I didn't try hard enough then. I don't need to ruin you, but then I have to protect them.
Protect them from what? Me? I'm not a killer.
No. Yes, you are. You killed Chris. And now you've killed my friends. I hate you.
That's the truth.
No. I hate you! And I don't want to see your face as a reminder of theirs. I stopped having a brother 7 years ago. You're a bloody murderer! Justin, I'm sorry you had to see that. Justin?
Your brother was right.
No! No!
I
am so sorry.
Mikey!
Yes. You killed an innocent man. Who happened to be with them. I am sorry. I am sorry. I have never had friends in this country. You want to know why? Because I am Russian. People hate me for where I am from. They either think I'm here to spy on them, kill them, or them. What do you think they just...
I've been crazy. And the funny thing is, I know I'm crazy. But I still do it. It's like I have no control.
You want to kill me, yes?
Go ahead. Kill me. That all us miners could be together in God's miners. It's crazy, I know. But I guess I am crazy.
Nothing else to say. We hope you enjoy the show. I'm Felix Westwood, and I'm the owner of this here company. This is a folder of all my employees. I love them. No, I don't. Why is he in this book? He's disgusting. Nicholas DeSantis, my best employee. He used to be an actor, but his career went south and he almost became a teacher. I saved him. Mr. Whiskers, my favorite one monocled mouse with a beautiful mustache. His hat was a gift from his mother. Snoop Dogg, always on the run, nowhere to go. I don't even know who this is, but he's amazing. He hides in all the right places and makes things good. Bigfoot, always hairy, always ready to go. Hillary, wow, that's gone. Oh, I didn't know his wife was in here. Alexander Hamilton, very nice, very kind, loves the ladies. She's on the outside, you'll catch her. Wow, I didn't know there was a woman in here. There's another woman.
What do I think about working for, Felix? It's not the worst job, and he's not the worst boss either. Pays minimum wage, and that's really gets you the necessities, I guess. It's really the only job I can maintain because of my crazy sister.
I'm cutting your pay to below minimum wage! Chris, did you pack all 72 crates of hamster crackers with the hamster charity?
What do I think of working for Felix? Easy, I hate this stupid job, man. If he doesn't fire me soon, I'll probably just quit.
Where is everyone? I hired a bunch of idiots!
Carl, have you filed the papers
for the hamster charity?
Whatever. See you guys later. What can I get for you?
long enough.
No, I'm most expensive thing on the menu.
Coming right up.
Now it's time to initiate my master plan. Calling all you desperate singles, have I got a competition for you?
Calling all you desperate singles, have I got a competition for you?
The first person that can successfully woo my best friend Jordan over the course of the next 2 days will win the prize of a lifetime.
$1 million? Of my own money, of course, because I'm so rich.
Come to the cafe on Maple Street before midnight tomorrow to sign up for the competition.
Hey, what's this?
It's a contest for money.
Money? Like how much money?
It's $1 million.
Are you serious? $1 million? Who's dumb enough to give that away?
It's that rich know-it-all, Felix.
Oh yeah, him. That sounds like something he'd do.
We can go sign up right now.
Are you going to?
Yeah, of course. I wouldn't pass that up.
Well, count me in too.
Race you there. First one there gets a better chance of winning.
Whatever, I'm gonna beat you.
No, you won't.
Watch me.
I mean, did you see what she was wearing? Like, I wore that same outfit 2 days ago. And she thinks she's gonna get away with it. And in front of him, too. Let me check that. It better not be her again. Like, seriously.
A competition for $1 million? Is this even for real? I'm, like, so totally gonna do this.
Sorry, girl. There's this competition I just heard about that I'm so totally gonna win. Wish me luck?
Dude, a competition? For money? Count me in. I'd do anything for $1 million. Literally anything.
Wow, think of all the things I could do with $1 million. I could pay for college, move to Europe, and travel the world. All I have to do is get some Jordan guy to like me. It should be a piece of cake. I'm naturally cute. He won't be able to resist me. Better get there fast!
This seems like the best way to go now.
This is stupid.
going on? You say competition? Is that money? Felix, just tell me when the competition starts, kid, big guy.
Sure, Sam.
Amelia, come on, come on, come on, come on!
Why are you dragging me?
Did you hear about the competition? I have a boyfriend already. You're such a lonely single.
What? You're signing me up for some dating thing? No, I can't! Not after what happened last time!
Seriously, how were you supposed to know he was allergic?
Grapes.
Yes.
steam with the sight of coffin.
I'm sorry, but we don't serve that here. Is there anything else I can get you that's on the menu?
I'm sorry about him, he's just joking. Maybe get him a cup of water instead.
Why get me water when I can just drown in my own tears?
Sure. Okay, coming right up, guys.
Can you do me a favor and stop being so pathetic? You are no fun to be around anymore.
Can't you be a little more supportive of me right now?
Hello, sexy. Are you Jordan?
Don't expect my line with me.
It's not Jordan. Hello, beautiful.
Are you Jordan, my chap?
I ain't no Jordan. And I don't need no man.
Alrighty then. Sorry to bother you. Oh, I found you, Jordan. It's such a pleasure to meet you, mon chéri.
I'm not Jordan. He is.
What? You're Jordan? Since when are you a guy?
Since the last time I checked.
Wait right here. I'll be right back.
Wait, you're Jordan? Seriously, it's you?
Yeah, why?
Oh, it's a pleasure to meet you. Excuse me, sweetie. I was here first. Who would ever talk to you, man hands? Don't get me started, you housewife wannabe!
Fight me!
Oh, gladly!
Don't worry, Jordan! Your Prince Charming is here to save you. I shall defeat thy monstrous, wretched beast for my love. Jordan!
Excuse me?
Yeah. I'm not Jordan. He's
male? Damn it, I really needed that prize money.
What money?
I mean,
Oh my gosh! He's so cute, like teleporting!
Whoa, Jordan! When did you become so popular?
Felix, help me!
Come back in a little while, guys.
That's not fair!
Yeah.
Oh!
Look at you, Casanova.
You're not helping, Felix. There's more important things to worry about. Like how all these people want my excessively hot pot.
It's more lukewarm.
I know. I was joking.
Speaking of crazy, here's one coming right now.
Hey, cutie. What's your name? Wait, you must be Jordan, aren't you?
Yeah. How would you know?
Oh, I don't know. I guess I must be like psychic or something.
Okay.
Anyway, you're super cutie and I'm drop dead gorgeous. We're perfect for each other. Here's my number. Call me.
That was really weird.
Yeah, that was.
Honestly, I probably imagined it.
Can't both be hallucinating. Hey there.
Sorry, do I know you?
No, but you will. It's just, I can't take my eyes off you. You're my one true love.
Excuse me?
Wow, after I complimented you with everything? What a waste of my time.
Okay, that was really weird. I haven't gotten this much attention in a year, let alone a single day. Not exactly Mr. Popular.
Do not start with this pity party again.
Wait, he's a guy? This is even weirder. Oh, heck no.
Yeah.
you have no self-confidence. You binge watch Dr. Phil when you're sad, and you will love me. Love me, Jordan! Love me, Jordan! 875309.
Is that my social security number?
Of course it is! Okay, you need to go. You can't get rid of me. I'll never leave you.
911! Please!
I'm so sorry. My sister, she's got a few screws.
Bless you.
If you know what I mean.
She's crazy.
Oh, by the way, call me.
What is going on with everyone today?
They're crazy.
Yeah, I've noticed.
Crazy enough.
What are you talking about?
Never mind, never mind.
What am I supposed to do? Why did Jordan have to be a guy? I'm not into that. Oh, I need the money. I really need the money.
How are you doing?
Hi. I'm good. I'm just looking for a dress.
Okay, so what kind of dress are you looking for?
Well, it's for my mom, and it's actually for a special occasion. She's trying to impress someone.
Okay. Like a dinner kind of dress, right?
Yeah. She's like my size, and she really likes two colors actually. Pink and like bluey turquoise.
Okay, I think I got just the fit. Come with me. Okay, so I'm gonna take you to this room where you can look at all the dresses that I'm gonna find you.
Okay, can I actually try them on? Because, you know, she is like my size.
Sure, okay, just follow me.
Great.
Okay, so this is all the dresses we have and the colors you wanted for your mom. You need that here.
Could you actually watch when I try them on so I can get like a second opinion?
Sure, okay. Montage time!
So, where do I pay for this?
Oh, I don't work here.
Sorry.
Jordan told me to meet him here. Where is he?
Psst! Felix! I'm here!
Jordan?
Shh! Don't use that name around here. I don't want to attract any more attention.
What's so important that we had to talk about that I had to come here?
I need your help dealing with all my new stalkers.
You know, I could be doing better things right now, Jordan.
I said, don't use that name around here. I don't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Jordan! Did you hear someone say Jordan? Oh my gosh, Jordan?
My darling!
Where is she?
I'm coming! Jordan, I'm here for you!
Where's my love? Hey, gorgeous. Well, not as gorgeous as me, but whatever. Have you missed me?
I don't even know who you are! What is wrong with you people?
Nothing, cutie. Yeah, nothing.
I'll save you, m'lady!
I'm not a woman! Put me down!
Oh, you're a guy.
This must be some sort of sick joke. It better be a joke.
It's obviously not a joke.
Felix, help, please!
Are you made of grapes? Because you're fine as wine.
Grapes? Really? Grapes?
What's going on here?
Hey, Felix. Is the competition still on?
What competition?
There's no competition.
Oh, come on, Felix. You know the competition. You're the one who organized it.
Felix, what is he talking about?
Sam, I swear I'll pay you to be quiet.
Felix?
Come on, you know the competition to woo Jordan and win the million bucks. Come on, why would you want to tell him? What do you want to... Oh, he's Jordan.
Oh, now I see.
Jordan.
Felix, how could you do this to me? I thought we were friends.
I did this for your own good.
My own good? I almost had a panic attack. I'm on the edge of insanity!
Get him! He's mine! He knows!
No, back off! Mine!
He's mine!
I'm in this million! He's mine!
Leave me alone! I am done with all of you! End it.
No.
You don't.
Sorry guys. Stop, this is over.
That's not fair. I worked so hard. We barely had enough time.
I went to such great extremes. I got nothing.
I'm gonna take my beauty someplace else.
Oh, how tragic. The pains of love. Goodbye, my darling.
I have way better people.
I could be stopping right now. Thank goodness. Stupid competition.
I just up with you, mon chéri.
I came as fast as I could. What happened?
I don't know. But why are we friends?
Because I'm rich. And you love me. And I'm rich. Did I mention I'm rich?
Yeah, once.
Twice. Now. Come on. I'll explain on the way.
Now's your chance, see? No one's here. Okay, I can do this. Yeah, do it. You can't now. Go get him, Tiger. Tiger.
What do you want? The competition's over.
I know. I just wanted to make sure you were okay.
Okay? My best friend tried to pay people $1 million to go out with me. So I'm not really that okay.
He didn't have to pay me. Do you, want to sit and talk to him?
Yeah. Sure.
I remember you.
Really?
Yeah. You do? It's kind of hard to forget. You almost killed me.
I didn't! It was an accident! I swear!
Amelia, it's fine. Don't worry.
It is? So you forgive me?
Yeah. I mean, it's not like you could have known I was allergic to grapes or anything.
So we're cool?
We're okay.
What can I get